Hey YouTube, this is MindTech. Welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be going over some of the basics of the resource monitor in Windows, such as how to monitor your CPU in a lot more detail than Task Manager gives you, how to monitor processes on the network, see IP addresses, see things that have exemptions in the firewall. This program gives you a lot of really great information, especially for troubleshooting problems such as viruses that you might have with your computer. So without any further ado, let's jump into some of the different tabs and things that you can view with the resource monitor. All right, so the first thing you're going to have to do in order to access the resource monitor is to either open up Task Manager, go to the Performance tab and select Open Resource Monitor, or you can also access it by going to the Start menu and searching up Resource Monitor. So if I go to the CPU tab here, you can view everything that is running on your computer. Applications are taking up the most CPU speed. You can sort here by clicking on the top, by which is taking up either the most or the least amount of resources. Plus you can also view graphs of all of your different CPU threads, just like you can view with Task Manager. And it has a lot of other data that I honestly don't know exactly what it means, like threads or average CPU, but you can view that right here. If you go on over to memory, again, mostly the same thing, but now you have a better chart that can tell you more information about what memory is in use, what memory is not actively in use. You can view this by whether or not there have been faults in the memory, by the amount of kilobytes it's working with, and by the amount of memory that it has to share with other applications. For the disk tab, this is actually kind of cool. It will tell you how many bytes per second the disks have been reading and writing. So here you can view the activity in real time. If I go to write, the one that is writing the most currently is the system. And a lot of these are obfuscated, so it only says like system or SVC host, which are processes that are internal to Windows. Since Audacity is open right now, it is writing about 100 bytes a second of data. Right at the top, you can view what processes overall have been reading and writing the most. So if we look at write bytes per second, as we can see, system is the number one and Microsoft Edge is the number two process. And finally, the network is probably the most useful thing that you can view in Resource Monitor. So let's say you have some sort of malware that is pinging some different server. So you can view what applications are currently active on the network. So something like the Kioni service for EBACAM, and you can see how many bytes of data that it's using currently. You can also view network activity, and here you can actually view the IP address of what the application is connecting to. So if you're wondering like, okay, so what is Kioni service connecting to? As you can see, that's connecting to my local computer or my local host. And then finally, you can view more detailed information about the type of connection that they're establishing. In this pane also, you can view whether or not your applications have been losing packets and also what ping they have or their latency. Something that is going to a remote address on the internet typically has a very high ping. I'm probably going to have to investigate that. Whereas something that is connecting to the local host, something like chrome.exe connecting to my local computer IP address, has a very small ping. And then finally, you can view listening ports, which tell you different ports in the firewall that these applications are using. So right now, the local system has these exceptions in the firewall, some for TCP and some for UDP, and it also tells you whether or not these applications are allowed or restricted. So if you add these blockages to the Windows firewall, but for some reason it's still getting through, then you might want to investigate that. So that's basically about it for this video, guys. The Task Manager and the Resource Monitor can be really useful resources to help you not only troubleshoot your computer, but also just view some cool information while you're gaming or while you're using applications. So with that said, guys, thank you all for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll catch you all in the next one. Bye-bye.